This morning, we're going to talk to one of the big turnover stories of this year, kiosk operator Frutas Holdings, Calvin Chua of Frutas and Balay in Frutas. Thanks so much for joining us. Hi, Calvin. Welcome to Market Edge.
Hey.
Hi. All right, so let's start with earnings. Pretty impressive numbers that you have there. If we could just show those numbers. For the second quarter, net income actually jumped 3.3 times to 23 million pesos as revenue there grew 1.7 times to 457 million. This brings your first half profit to 29.3 million. That's an impressive turnaround from a net loss of 8.6 million in the same period last year. Clearly, you're able to sustain the turnaround from the first quarter. Can you tell us what's working?
Basically, it's a combination of the economy coming back, mm-hmm. right? There's a lot of activity in the economy with the malls mm-hmm. coming back on stream, cinemas coming back on stream, as well as us having a lot of strategic initiatives to improve our margin.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's break it down. Is it more top line stellar performance or more cost cutting measures?
It's both top line. So top line grew 38% from first quarter. Mm-hmm. That coming off a strong first quarter already, and also cost cutting. Not really cost cutting, but cost optimization, mm-hmm. both on gross margins and operating costs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So let's talk about some of the challenges facing, the industry that you're in that could dictate, how the tides will turn for the second half of this year. Let's talk about sugar. A lot of your brands use sugar and flour, both commodities caught in the middle of a super inflation, as some would describe it. For sugar, is there a shortage? Are you feeling the shortage that everyone is talking about, whether in your inventory or in the price?
We are currently monitoring prices of sugar, as we have seen in the news, right? There's potentially a shortage because of the importation, but we haven't really seen it impact our cost of goods. As you would know, some of our best SKUs or best-selling SKUs do not use sugar.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So these include buko juice.
The more natural. What about for flour? Because you're betting big on the bread side. I heard Philbake this morning saying that they're going to have to raise prices because the flour price is just going up. What about for you?
The same thing. Yeah, the same thing for baked goods. We are not pricing them as low as your local bakery. We are slowly moving to higher value-added products, such as donuts and cakes, so we don't feel as much cost pressure.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right, so if you don't feel the cost pressures, it's safe to say that Frutas Holdings, for this year so far, has not adjusted prices of its products and has no intention of raising prices for the rest of the year?
We have actually increased for certain SKUs, mm-hmm. including some Jamaican patties, fruit shakes, but these are very tactical. We have also just try to pass on as little as possible to our customers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. When you say tactical, what's the reason behind that tactic for raising prices when you're saying you're not really experiencing much of a cost pressure?
Some of it is anticipatory.
Mm-hmm.
We think that certain raw materials will continue to increase, so as early as possible, we are also trying to already anticipate those margin impacts.
Mm-hmm. Certain raw materials, if they're not flour or sugar, what sort of raw materials are you anticipating the increases in?
So for one, beef, the price of beef has increased.
Mm-hmm.
Certain fruits, fruit prices have also increased.
Mm-hmm.
So for certain SKUs, we've also increased for juices.
And are you planning to implement more increases for the rest of the year, or that's it?
I think we're pretty much done.
Mm.
with our tactical price increases, what we are trying to do is further optimize our costs so that we don't have to increase prices anymore.
Mm-hmm. All right. So in general, Calvin, give us a big picture. How is the second half of this year looking for Frutas Holdings when it comes to growth? Do you think you'll be able to keep the momentum in your earnings going and when it comes to expanding and adding more stores or kiosks to the network?
So as mentioned by Lester in our press release yesterday, July was pretty good for us, exceeded all our expectations. Usually third quarter is less strong or weaker than our other quarters, but we've had a good July, and the first few days of August was also equally good. So I think customer demand continues to be strong, and we expect that to continue to fourth quarter.
And what about adding new kiosks? What about growth plans for the rest of the year?
So in terms of additional outlets, we've added 20 for March to July. We intend to add maybe 40 to 50 more until the end of the year.
Mm-hmm. Adding 40 to 50 more, these will be store owned or franchises?
Similar to our strategy, we intend to keep them mostly company-owned.
All right. And final question, Calvin. When you talk about expansion, it's not just within the industry that you're already operating in or the brands that you have for the kiosks. What about M&As? Are you looking... I know that there was an exciting news, Lingnam. Frutas bought Lingnam in July, at least finalized in July. How many more M&As are in the pipeline for the next 6 to 12 months?
So we did our Balay IPO. Mm-hmm. So a definite focus of inorganic expansion will definitely be baked goods. But we continue to look at the other segments of our group as well.
Mm-hmm. And beyond the group, I know that in 2021, I remember this got a lot of investors and news watchers very excited. You were supposed to get into healthcare business with Sure Health. That fell through the cracks, but are you reconsidering or maybe looking at other industries to enter? Health still, perhaps?
So I think as a management team and as a board, we had decided to really keep Frutas Holdings focus on food and beverage. So if ever there will be investments outside food and beverages, that would be probably be done by the shareholders rather than Frutas itself.
All right. Are the major shareholders considering M&As outside of this industry? You can blink to say yes.
So there are a few sectors that we are currently looking at least at the shareholder level. Of course, healthcare is quite high at that priority list. Also, probably fintech and maybe real estate.
Fintech. All right. So healthcare, fintech, and real estate. Exciting time set. We're going to be watching for more exciting news from Frutas Holdings. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Calvin. Always a pleasure to speak with you, and congratulations on the turnaround this year.
Thanks, Mimi.
All right.